Welcome to our chorus concert. Hi. We are celebrating Music in Our Schools Month, which is the month of March. We are so lucky here at Blue Ridge. We have an incredibly supportive school board, administration, parents, community members that support arts in the schools. We have so many students that the arts, music, is the reason that they come to school in the morning. And so if it were not for you, we would not have such a strong music program at Blue Ridge. So give yourselves a round of applause. We appreciate you. Thank you. Tonight we're gonna start with the Mozart Coronation Mass in C. This is a masterwork. If you've been coming to these concerts for a while, this may sound familiar. We do four masses that rotate, so the students get a chance to sing all four of them. This was written in 1779, ooh, a long time ago, by Mozart. He died when he was only 35, but he wrote over 600 pieces of music. And I think that's incredible to think what he could have accomplished if he had lived longer. But we have this piece of music that has stood the test of time. People have been performing this piece of music for over 250 years, which to me says that this must be pretty good. People wouldn't keep performing it if it wasn't amazing. We do this music for several reasons. One, because it's in Latin, and it helps the students actually with their vocabulary. We learn about cognates and false cognates and word roots, and it helps them when they take standardized tests or SATs, all those things. We also do this music because it helps them become better singers, which is the whole point of being in a choir, right? Is to become a better singer. This music's really, really challenging. And then, of course, to become more musically literate, right? So I want the students to be able to read music because maybe someday they're gonna be in a church choir or a community chorus, and I want them to know how to read music when I'm not around. So this helps them read music really, really well. You'll notice in this work we have soloists, but they're really more like quartets. So you'll have one on a part, a soprano, an alto, a tenor, and a bass, singing a solo together. They'll be featured, they'll come down to the microphones, you'll get to experience that, they sound incredible. It's very difficult to sing this music, one on a part, so I wanna commend these soloists for working so hard on this music. Thank you, you guys did great. And then of course, I want to commend our incredible pianist, Mrs. Kristen Burkhart. This is not really a piano part. This is a piano reduction, which means they take all the instruments of the orchestra and they try to take all those hundreds of parts and reduce it down to two hands for the piano. So Mrs. Burkhart is trying to play the trumpet and the trombone and the tuba and the violin and the viola and the cello and the bass and all of these instruments, and she's gonna do a fantastic job because we love Mrs. Burkhart. She is great. We also learned this piece of music on solfege, which the students loved so much. Look at their faces full of joy. And count singing. Solfege, if you do not know, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. And count singing, one and two and three and four and. And once again, really helps them solidify the music, learn it really well, and helps with that music learning. I really would love to have them. I know, the crab's out. I'm so sorry. I know, I can't stop. So they make fun of me, it's so cute. So I would love for them to sing it for you on solfege right now. I will not do that to them, but I really would like to. And then this is a three movement work right now. We're gonna do a Kyrie, a Gloria, and a Credo, and we kindly ask for you to hold your applause until we're done with the Credo. I will stop talking, this is the most talking I will do all night, I promise. And then we're going to sing for you the Mozart Coronation Mass in C. Please enjoy this masterwork.
Thank you. She begs,
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 proud of them for pulling that off, though. That is, yes, incredibly difficult music, though. Yes. So proud. I need a nap now. But there's more. The students you see before you, this is not in the program. They decided they wanted to sing this for you. They sang this at District Chorus this year. It is a piece called I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud. It is absolutely beautiful, and I hope that you enjoy this piece from our select choir.
Thank you.
to welcome to the stage Jocelyn France, who is also helping with tech. So we were really lucky this year. She had an independent study with us, period 8, which is when we have 6th grade chorus. And Jocelyn is planning to become a music teacher, and I thought it would be really lovely for her to be able to help us with some of our music. So Jocelyn is going to conduct, and she actually taught them the piece that you're going to hear, the Shenandoah piece. And the students absolutely love her, and it's just been so lovely to have someone else helping out in class with these amazing 6th graders.
Funga Alafia is a joyful greeting song that means welcome. It uses text from three West African languages.
River found in Virginia and West Virginia.
Thank you.
York, New York is from the 1977 movie with the same name.
It was most famously sung by Frank Sinatra.
While we are transitioning, I'll try to get rid of all the housekeeping information that we have going on. So hopefully when I send papers home with the students, they give them to you so you know what's going on. But in case they don't, here's all the information you need to know. Our 7th and 8th grade chorus was invited to perform with the Penn State Scranton Chorus on Saturday, April 20th, which is a huge honor. They heard them sing, they really thought they were incredible, and they wanted them to perform with them. I'm very excited for this group. If your student did not inform you about this, on the edge of the stage over here, I have all kinds of papers, just in case nothing ever makes its way home to you. So the blue paper there is for the 7th and 8th graders. It's a permission slip. You could just sign it tonight and give it right back to me and leave it right on the edge of the stage. There's a little manila folder there. You can put it in there so that I get it back. And this way you don't have to worry about your student giving it back to me. So the trip, like I said, is Saturday, April 20th. There's a bus that goes down to Penn State Scranton for the students to sing in the concert. It should be, I think we leave around 1 p.m. We'll be back around 6 p.m. or so. Thank you, Jocelyn. You're the best. Thank you. I hope they can all make it. And then second of all, our high schoolers that you just heard back there, they were trying to do a chorus competition. I think that they can handle it. They're super talented. Right, chorus back there? Yes? Yes. Woo! Yeah, okay, right, yeah. So it is Music in the Parks. It's at Hershey Park. But I need enough of them to go for us to do this competition, because if only like 10 of them sign up, then it's not gonna work. So I need to submit how many students are going to Hershey Park by tomorrow. So if your student would like, a high school student would like to go to this chorus competition, there's yellow papers over on the edge of the stage for them to go. I would like a deposit, but if you can at least give me the permission slip so I know that they are able to go, that would be great. So if you can fill that out, it's over there. And then of course, we're going to Florida, high schoolers. Yes, I know, we're very excited. To perform in Universal Studios, April 2nd through the 6th. Luggage drop-off, if they did not tell you, is Monday morning, April 1st at 7 a.m. You have to bring the luggage for the students. They can't bring it. An adult has to bring their luggage at 7 a.m. on April 1st. All this information is in your program. Also over there is more Florida information in case you haven't gotten anything about Florida. There's more stuff over there if you need more information about that trip. Sorry, I thought I wouldn't talk a lot, and here I am yapping away. We have three choirs, really, before you. You guys have to talk about the stage, right? So we have a men's choir, we have a women's choir, and then we have the whole group. So we're gonna do the men's choir first, and then the women's choir. The men are gonna sing, "Will the Circle Be Unbroken," which they did at Young Men's Choral Fest this year. They loved that piece, so they asked to do it again. The women are going to do a French tongue twister called Tante, which translates to, "Your tea, has it removed your cough?" It's kind of like one of those, how much wood could a woodchuck chuck? Does it make sense? No, but it's a cool tongue twister. And it's a tongue twister in French, so if they can do it in French, that'll be really cool. And then our entire choir will sing three pieces for you. Okay, hopefully I'm done talking. Here is the men's chorus. Thank you.
Jack the Knife is a jazz standard.
It was written 100 years ago for the Three Penny Opera.
The song tells a story about a mobster.
You'll Never Walk Alone is from a musical, Carousel.
It has become the theme song for the Liverpool soccer team and is sung in dedication to the fans lost in Hillsborough.
And we have an incredible soloist, Julia Hobbs.
Chin up high, and don't be afraid. My Country 'Tis of Thee was written in 1744.
This patriotic song celebrates America.
Thank you so much for coming to our concert this evening. We hope to see you at the cabaret concerts in May. And like I said, if you need any paperwork, it's on the edge of the stage. Enjoy the nice weather. Have a great night, everyone. Thank you so much.